Loudshirt is a bizarre name for a brewery, but all became clear once I met the masters behind the shirts.
We've been friends a long, long time. We've often worn shirts like this, but the day we were trying to think of a name, we couldn't think of one. And someone said, why don't you make it something that's sort of relevant to yourselves, that make you stand out in the crowd? There are 2,000 breweries in England, I think. So we wanted to be one that people wouldn't forget. So we like vibrant beers and we like wearing vibrant shirts. And it's different.
You guys have the third biggest brewery in Brighton at the moment.
Do we now? Oh. Yeah, I think that's right, yeah.
We were
yeah.
second, but we've been pushed yeah, down yeah, a space.
Yeah. What was your dream? What were you start to make beer?
That's what matters,
yeah. Yeah, well, we wanted a business which was going to be fun, really. We've both done other jobs, which are mainly sort of desk-bound. We like the idea of making something, so something a bit more creative than what we've been doing in the past.
We were accountants before.
So. We both brewed, you know, at home on small scale, so it was something we were interested in. It's just like a dream, you know, to have our own brewery. Being in Brighton, we thought was a good idea. So the idea of being sort of vibrant and loud and Brighton all sort of came together. So
it's party sound. Yeah. We have lots of parties here at the brewery.
Right.
Yeah, we're not a sort of typical brewery because we like to meet our customers as much as we can. So we're very open. People are you're very welcome to come along and see us. And we very regularly hold events here with entertainment of varying sorts. And we're, you know, planning to expand that over the next year.
We've registered for the Brighton Fringe, so we'll be a venue for the Fringe. So we may get some comedy acts in here, some theatre. We might get some quiz nights, all sorts of things, really. We sponsor the local football team, Whitehawk FC. So we get people coming in after matches, a bit of a social gathering. We want to make it a bit of a community venue for the local people here, yeah.
We're still, you know, what we are is a brewery, but we want to be a brewery that entertains our clients and sells beer from the brewery here.
Yeah. And then they go away and tell their local landlady that they should buy our beer. We're going to start organising more brewery tours as well. Yeah. Tasting, we've had some of those with beer tasting with meat and cheese and things.
What kind of beer do you guys make?
We make vibrant, loud beer. So we don't do the sort of standard bitters, lagers, etc. We make highly hopped IPAs. We make a Belgian style broom beer. We made 6.6%. They do generally tend to be above average in strength. So our typical beer is sort of 5% or above. But we also do a 6.6% stout, which won silver medal in Southeast Britain strong beer competition.
You guys designed
the labels? Yeah, well, we sort of, a friend of ours helped us, but she presented lots of different images. I remember the one we picked was a Bob Dylan EP from the 1970s called Blowing in the Mind, where his hair was like beer bubbles. And so our design are beer bubbles from Bob Dylan's hair. Watch out for more events. Follow us on Loudshirt Beer on social media. Lots of things happening at the brewery. Please come.
This is Willy Ranieri for Legislative News.